Okay, now, so to introduce this video, it's already been raining today, and it's already flooded in here earlier, before even now. But radar says that a whole bunch more rain is coming, and so what I want to do is film this presently only wet and damp and dirty area. I don't know if you can see below the feet of my older billy goat who's studying. And you see a brownness on the floor. I don't know that you can see the actual standing water. Earlier, when it first came in, you could see where the water came through holes in the various locations in the concrete where there's gaps in the pour. My goal, eventually, is to dig a trench up to the side to put in a drainage tile and to divert the water away from the milking parlor so that you don't have all this standing water in here, which obviously you don't want in the milking room. And go around this side. Now you don't see right away, but a lot of water comes off of here. I don't know if it's even visible. A lot of water comes down this off of this house and runs right down through and washes down to the edge of the building and curves around and goes around it to some extent, but not all of it. And then some comes through and permeates the area to the point where you have all of it come in here. I have a drain over there and it goes down there once you clean this drain. Recently, now you see the little brown sediment here. This whole floor was covered where it looked like it was a coating of chocolate. I mean, or a big chocolate bar. I mean, really disgusting. And the water was at least, I don't know how deep it was, but I think that some of this right here might be some of the watermark. Because looking at the sediment here on this board, I'm not sure how much of that is sediment, how much is insect droppings, but this whole floor was covered all the way underneath to the highest point, which is over an inch and a half of incline. And well, this crate that usually sits under here, as you see, it has some of that same sediment. We'll get it up here in a better light and get myself out of light. There you go. Now you can see. See, it's just coated with a kind of a brown, it's dry now, it's a combination of clay and humus and stuff. But anyway, so the water was at least that deep at that point, so it was over an inch and a half deep in the corner where that broom is and where that drain is. As the sediment comes in and chunks and, you know, stops up the drain, I have to go by through there and get the stuff out of it. So, and of course, there's one of my nosy goats wants to know what it is I have in my hand, and they can't be eaten. And that is cocoa. Down below is peat. And this is espresso. And he likes to eat my fingers if I let him. You know, theoretically, they're not carnivorous. Some reason or another, I seem to taste edible. I don't know how long it is until this rain deluge begins, so I will pause this for a moment just so that I'll go look at the other babies and name them all for those who are terribly curious. Maybe later I'll film my new pet chipmunk. Over there is a grandpa goose. I call him grandpa because he's old enough. He's got an arthritic wing. The one standing up on there, that's Mocha. She just gave birth to one right there who's Regina. This one right down here, that's Sugar. Her mother's coming at us, and that's Samantha. And over in the corner, the black one coming at us. They're all coming at us. Got the black one there sniffing the butt. That's Caroline. So that is all of my animals. These are all does. Over there, you saw one doe and two bucks. And then, of course, one goose is over here, and then I've got four geese over there. I'm going to have to rearrange them because this goose, gander, if you will, is a breeding importance. Our last batch of eggs either came out infertile or rotted or what, I don't know. But we've got one male and one adult male, and two adult females, and one unknown chick who's almost an adult, which I don't know if they're male or female. They're speckled, and the others are white. So that's my, other than my cat, and my recent addition is Charisse the chipmunk. I called him Charisse because that in Greek means grace, and the poor thing survived somehow or another, the cat, without dying. In fact, apparently again, not getting an injury. Came up with the thing. It looked pretty much either stunned or dead, but I took it away from the cat. No apparent marks or bleeding. Of course, since the bunny rabbits have either died of shock or bleeding, I don't know. I didn't really expect it to live, but so far it's lived, and seems to starting to get accustomed to its immediate accommodations. So I've got a pet chipmunk, which I've kind of always wanted. I say always, for a few years anyway. So I guess I'll pause it here, and then because there's no fast water running at the moment, and then if the water comes running down, I'll run out here and I'll film again.